Happy holidays. Christmas was always a big thing in our house. I was very excited about it. My sister, Christmas was huge in our family and in our family's family as well. This time of year always brings back memories for me. And this poem that I wish to share now, well, I hope it's able to bring some memories back for you. The Unknown Guest. Several pounds and inches in a widow's peak ago, when I was twice as wise and half as nice, a calendar was something in the kitchen with a picture, and its one and only purpose for existence was to tell me just how long it was until Christmas. Just how long I was going to have to wait. And wait. And wait. Until those fleecy days when people pause to dim the lamp and light the tree, and once again receive the gifts of glowing hearths and flowing hearts. When children perch on weary, shop-worn, padded knees and whisper fervent wishes as their groaning grown-ups bustle by, convulsed in budget-busting Yuletide cheer, recalling the days they sat there too on Santa's knee and wished without the least suspicion. To ease the hurt of growing up and learning disbelief, some say, well, Christmas, after all, it's really only for the kids, you know. And anyway, since plastic angels now wear drip-dry Dacron wings, it's really kind of hard to catch that good old spirit. And who has time to sit and let the spirit do the catching? Flocks of turkeys, fields of yams, and a galaxy of cranberries ago, in my grandmother's home, come Christmas time, traditions came to roost. In Grandma's home, come Christmas time, traditions were traditional. If a Yuletide tradition were fresh out of work, down on its heels with no place to go, Grandma's was quick to take it in, find it a place in her life and ours. A holiday table can never be set without including a place for the unknown guest. Now, the unknown guest to the grown-ups meant a neighbor dropping by, or a man with a flat in need of a phone, or a cousin from Portland passing through, and they occasionally showed up. But to me, the unknown guest was an angel, or a shepherd, or a camel with his wise man, or a little boy like me, only shinier and in need of lodging, and they always showed up, like the magi and the manger and the flying molten star. They were there. They abided. They kept. We have another flying star this time around to remind us that peace on earth among men of goodwill is truly glory to God in the highest. So, it is Christmas time. Not once again, but still. And it will keep us in its promise if we will keep him in our hearts. Merry Christmas.
We'd like to take 1 minute. Thank you for coming, first of all. We have a very special part of our group that we want to honor tonight, and that's Jana Kisner. Would you please come up here with me? Jana has given so much dedicated time and service and love into the Lamplighters, and we just can't say enough about how much she means to us, to the university, and to the music program. Jana, we love you and we thank you.
And Jana, I just want to add a word, because it's very rare that you get to hire an adjunct instructor who has had the impact that you've had on these students. And I see heads shaking up here, and they know it. And more than that, on the community here at Waynesburg, we thank you so much for all your work.
As they're moving, I just wanted to take a minute to tell you about the Lamplighters. They meet twice a week, every semester, and we have a wonderful time learning all different types of music. This year, we got to perform the 4A Requiem with an instrumental ensemble, which was just an amazing thing to be able to do and for them to accomplish. I was just incredibly proud of our Lamplighters for what they've done, learning such a major piece in Latin and performing it here and in Pittsburgh. Our Lamplighters and our symphonic band have not only been in Pittsburgh, they've been in Washington, D.C. this year, and they've also been all over Waynesburg in all different churches and nursing homes and little places and banquets and all kinds of fun things. And I just want to take 1 minute to say thank you to those that donate and support the music program, because it makes a huge difference in what we are able to do. And as we're getting finished and set in place, when we were warming up downstairs, someone very special came in the door, and I said to myself, well, I know he's here, so I have to tell you that the founder of the Lamplighters is here with us. More than 50 years ago, he got some guys together, right, Nelson, in the men's dorm and said, why don't we sing in harmony and do something? And they started singing. They invited some girls, and they became the Lamplighters. And from then on, we have been this beautiful choir, and I'm so happy that we exist. Fuzzy Randolph, where are you? Where are you, Fuzzy? Where is he? Oh, there he is. Here he is.
Wow-wee. Thank you very much. And I'm kind of at a loss for words, except the old Lamplighters were better looking than these guys. No, it was a beautiful program. And this Rhonda DePriest, ladies and gentlemen, is a go-getter. And Waynesburg University is now, in my book, back on the same level as it was years ago. It is now a conservatory. And you people have helped to make it that way. But just fantastic. And woo, and thank you all for coming. All right.
And now I would like to introduce you to the Symphonic Band of Waynesburg University with their leader, Dr. Rhonda DePriest.
Thank you.
We're going to call this the Celebration of the Adjunct Instructors. And welcome to the podium. Turn around, Mr. Olisar. Mr. Jeremy Olisar. Welcome him to the podium, please. I also have to tell you about these three gentlemen standing over here because last year, Caleb and Samantha May were our two trumpets. And now, as you can see, our trumpet section exploded this year. And we have some very, very talented young men. Caleb Gomer, Doug Pollock, yes, Nod, and Ryan Lemon. We're so glad they're here with us. And they're going to bring you a little holiday cheer, bugler style.
Thank you.
We're going to end tonight on a piece that means a lot to me personally. I've only had the opportunity to conduct it one other time, and it was one of the first years I was here. I believe we had maybe 30 members of the band at that time, and our concerts were over in the GPAC. Some of you guys might remember that we did a Saturday night concert and a Sunday afternoon concert just so that we could get all the parents in the room. And now we have this lovely space that we can all meet together. It's a little easier on the students' schedules also to do one concert. We kind of hate the, if you have something you'd like to redo, we don't get a chance to redo it the next day. But we do so love this space. And be able to have the use of the organ, as you saw with the choir and those types of things in this lovely Steinway up here. So we feel very, very blessed and very grateful to have this space, and want to thank the administration and the board members and everybody who had something to do with getting this space built. We really, really appreciate that very much. And to have a room downstairs that we're going to party in a few minutes, okay? So y'all can be a part of that. We also are grateful for that as the large ensemble room for the brass and percussion, because back in the day, we were meeting in Benedum, the lower floor in 108, and my back was against the whiteboard, and all those trumpets and drums were coming at me. I was fearful of my life some days. So so it's so wonderful to have space to work in as we do. I see all the choir members over there too, and I want you to see this. How many of you are not music ministry or arts administration music majors? Raise your hand. Band? Volunteer Army. Yay. And they actually look like they're having a little bit of fun, so that's kind of great. That's what we're hoping is happening. On this particular piece, and you've seen them on a couple of other pieces, we have some visitors with us. You can see in their program some members of PA Cyber School and also Waynesburg Central High School, and they've come to help us kind of fill out the ranks on this piece, and we hope you enjoy Alfred Reed's Russian Christmas music.